How do you successfully co-parent children after a divorce? Our next guest has figured out a way to do it.
It's more about applying a business-like approach to the tasks at hand rather than dealing with the emotions of the situation. Easier said than done.
Mindy Barnett is here to give us her best tips on co-parenting because she's raising two elementary-age children with her ex-husband.
And she writes all about it in her book, Intermission, How Fever, Friendships, and Faith Took Me to the Second Act. Welcome, Mindy. Nice to have you here.
Nice to have you. It's fervor. I think that was my mistake and a typo, but fervor, passion.
Fervor, not fervor. Fever.
But fever. You
fever
can get
works
some fever
too.
When you're angry and you have to like keep it suppressed, right?
So how long have you been co-parenting?
Well, about 3 years now.
Okay.
We got separated a little over 3.5 ago, and the divorce will be officially 3 years in June.
And how old are the kids, or how old were the kids when you separated?
They were, I'm trying to think, they were about like 5, 6 and like 3, 4, so pretty young.
Yeah.
And they're still young. I mean, my older one is now in 5th grade and my younger is in 1st, and you know, it's a difficult for both of them for different reasons. The older one obviously remembers more. Mm-hmm. The younger one doesn't understand why mommy and daddy aren't in the same house.
Right.
Especially when we do get along for the most part.
Sure.
You know, we didn't get divorced because we didn't like each other. It just wasn't, you know, viable for like the long term.
Right.
But to get into the theme, I definitely think being a, you know, a full-time PR person and kind of being on a teeter-totter on a regular basis between the client and the media, which, as I'm sure you know, you know, can sometimes be a little tricky with high intense situations and deadlines and et cetera, et cetera. So I think what makes our relationship successful is my implementation, if you will, of the business tactics and how to sort of take a step back and take your emotions out of it. And thankfully, he's followed suit for the most part.
Yeah, but you know, saying those words and actually living them are two different things,
totally
aren't they?
Totally agree. Not easy.
Well,
every day is a work in progress. But yeah.
Okay, let's start with tactic number one. You say learn to stretch, and we're not talking about doing this.
No.
Although that
yoga helps too.
Yoga does. Right. No, I learned to basically be open to not necessarily going in the direction that you'd want. Now, it's very difficult in a relationship that was once obviously a marriage partnership and to now like do that, right? Because before, someone had more of a passion about a certain issue and the other one would concede, and vice versa for the other partner. But now you're sort of, we both want our own thing, but you really do need to constantly think about the child as the main focus. And I think when you do that, and I'll give you a quick example. Recently, I wanted to go away with my children on a weekend that was technically my ex-husband's weekend because we flip every other weekend with the kids. And for a variety of reasons, I'll spare you the details, I really needed to do it that particular weekend. And at first, he wasn't really overly excited about swapping because it kind of screws up the schedule. And I think he had some plans that were easier to change, but he still had the plans and he wanted to maintain his plans. But thankfully, he eventually did concede because the kids really wanted to go. And if they didn't go that one weekend, we weren't able to go that year, this year.
So he did business tactic number two, which is take the high road.
And so did I.
Yeah.
So that situation, to stick with that, turned into somewhat of a heated discussion. And also, now that the book is out, it's obviously a very bird's eye view of our relationship and the good, the bad, and the ugly, as well as some other life lessons I throw in there about working in TV news and things like that.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, when we butt heads, which happens, life, and especially when you're divorced, we both try our very, very best to maintain a distance with one another. So you take your, you know, you might be more inclined to curse off your ex, you know, because you lived with them, you have a more casual founded relationship. But if you look at it as if they were a client or they were your boss, you really keep that in your mind. You have to train yourself to communicate that way. It can definitely work, and it's worked for us, for sure.
And we're running out of time, so I'm just going to kind of run through them. It's okay. Trust is a must, which I think is pretty obvious.
Yeah. Right.
Respect is a big one.
It kind of goes back to that rule number two. You have to look at the person and remember, you have to give them respect.
Right.
Treat them like they are your coworker.
Right.
That's key.
And don't give up on each other.
And don't give up on each other, because there's good days, there's bad days, and if things do get very heated.
But you've already given up on each other. In a way,
but you have to maintain, you still have a relationship with them as a co-parent, and that's never, ever going to end, ever. Right. Yeah. So you might as well make the best of it.
The
kids okay at
this point? The kids are great. Yeah, they're in Boston right now with their dad.
So you've learned to make it work.
Yes, we have. Right. And I want to pass those lessons on to everybody else because it's not easy.
No. All right. Okay.
Again, the book is called Intermission. Mindy Barnett, thanks so much.
Thank you.
Thanks for having me.
All right.
We'll be right back.